Hello to all students. I hope you are doing fine. Today we are going to discuss circulatory system in fishes. To understand the circulatory system of fishes, first of all we have to look at the anatomy of fish heart. So here is the diagram of a fish which is known as bony fish. It is a kind of bony fish. I have taken out a heart of a fish and made a diagram for you to understand it completely. The fish heart is composed of technically only two chambers, but some scientists some zoologists believe that there are four chambers, but actually there are two chambers, atrium and ventricle. There are two chambers. Fish heart is usually single circuit. Single circuit heart means blood enters in the heart only once and leaves the heart only once, because human body and mammals and some other birds and reptiles, they have double circuit heart. Blood enters and leaves the heart two times. So we will discuss in the later lectures. So the circulatory system, the heart of the fish, is single circuit. First of all, if you look at the diagram of a heart, it consists of a small chamber which is known as sinus venosus, which brings deoxygenated blood towards heart. When it contracts, blood moves into the chamber which is known as atrium. When atrium contracts, blood goes into ventricle, which is the second portion of the heart. When ventricle contracts, the blood moves into the small chamber-like part, which is known as conus arteriosus, and then into ventral aorta. So basically, technically, there are only two chambers, atrium and ventricle. But some zoologists think that there are four chambers, atrium, ventricle, sinus venosus, and conus arteriosus are also the part of the heart. Anyhow, it doesn't make any difference. So now let's discuss the circulation of blood in the body of fish. So first of all, deoxygenated blood from all over the body is collected by venous system, network of veins spreading all over the body. They collect deoxygenated blood. And you know what is deoxygenated blood? Deoxygenated blood is a blood which contain less amount of oxygen. So deoxygenated blood is collected from all over the body and brought into the anterior portion towards heart. Then it enters into a sinus venosus. From sinus venosus, blood enters into atrium, then into ventricle, then into conus arteriosus, and from conus arteriosus it opens into ventral aorta. Ventral aorta takes this deoxygenated blood into gills. Gills are special organs which are located at the anterior region of the body, just behind the mouth. There is a water flowing on the surface of the gills. Water contains rich amount of oxygen which is diffused into the blood of the fish. So deoxygenated blood is transported towards gills so that it can become oxygenated. After becoming oxygenated, it comes out from the gills with the help of dorsal aorta, and dorsal aorta takes this oxygenated blood into the all parts of the body through arterial system. So this is a simple summary of circulatory system. But first of all, the complicated part is circulatory system which transport blood towards or leaves from gills. So I made a diagram from you and taken this system right over here. So let's suppose this is a heart. Heart receives deoxygenated blood. This heart, when pumps, the deoxygenated blood moves into a blood vessel which is known as ventral aorta. Ventral aorta divides into arterioles, and then into capillaries. There are five branches which take off from this ventral aorta, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and they divide and subdivide and form a network which is known as gill capillaries. These gill capillaries are spreading on the surface of the gills. Here gaseous exchange takes place. The CO2 present in the blood, deoxygenated blood, is given out, and oxygen from the gills present in the water is taken in, and deoxygenated blood becomes oxygenated. After becoming oxygenated blood, these blood capillaries join again and form efferent arteries. So the difference between efferent arteries and afferent arteries takes blood towards gills, while efferent arteries takes blood away from the gills. So this is the difference. So afferent mean to bring in towards gills, and efferent mean exit. take blood away from the gills. So there is a there should be clearance of afferent arteries and efferent arteries. When efferent arteries join together, they form a big vessel which is known as dorsal aorta. Dorsal aorta contains oxygenated blood, which is then supplied to the whole body, and oxygenated blood is given to all parts of the body. So this is how the circulatory system has completed. So to make it more easier, I have made a scheme for you. If you look at this scheme, it will be very easy to learn all the steps of the circulatory system of fish. So first of all, body. As you know that body contains deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood is collected by a venous system. Venous system composed of veins, venules. This system brings deoxygenated blood into sinus venosus, which is the first small chamber of the heart. Sinus venosus pumps the blood into atrium, and atrium pumps the blood into ventricle. As you know that this is a single circuit heart, and each step there are valves. At each step there are valves which control the backflow of the blood. From ventricle, when it contracts, the blood moves into conus arteriosus, and from conus arteriosus blood moves into ventral aorta. If you look at this diagram, so this is the sinus venosus, the first chamber. It contracts, blood moves into atrium. Atrium contracts and blood moves into ventricle. Ventricle contracts, blood moves into conus arteriosus, and from there conus arteriosus to ventral aorta. Ventral aorta carries this blood towards gills with the help of afferent vessels, afferent arteries. So afferent arteries take this deoxygenated blood towards gills, where oxygenation takes place, and after oxygenation, efferent vessels take this oxygenated blood towards dorsal aorta. Dorsal aorta receives oxygenated blood from the gills and then transport it to the different parts of the body, and in this way whole circulatory system has completed. So I hope you have understood this topic. Still, if you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section, and you can also contact me on WhatsApp number, or you can have, if you want to learn any other topic you wish to, let me know and I will glad to teach you that topic. Thank you so much, and see you in the next lecture. Bye.